Hello, folks. I'm just about to start my first solo motorcycle tour, first motorcycle tour, period, but I'm doing it solo. It's just a week long, 6 day job. I'm starting from here in Chippenham in Wiltshire, and I'm going basically round Ireland. So I'm going to overnight in North Wales and then shoot over from the north of Wales to Dublin and anti-clockwise, basically take the coastal route around Ireland. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. I'm pretty new to motorbiking after a 20 odd year break of small bikes. I did my test 8 months ago and I've got a bigger bike now. So I'm just going to take you through what I think I'm going to need to take. I'm not going to go into the personal stuff, clothes, all that kind of stuff, pants, socks, wash kit, you know, I'm not going into that. I'm just going to go through the bike essentials and the sort of tech kit I'm going to take with me, because I'm going to be filming it, basically to give me something to do. Okay. So to start off with, documentation and essential sort of personal effects, not the TV remote control. Wallet with a credit card that I don't normally use, but I'll take just in case I get drama with my other card. AA, I've got all the benefits with AA. It's my first sort of motorcycle tour, so I've chosen somewhere reasonably close to home, Ireland, where I know I'll have no drama. So if the worst comes to the worst, I'll get low loaded and come back here with my tail between my legs. Phone, I'll use that. I've got a waterproof case for it. I use that for navigation as well. I haven't got a bike sat nav, so I'm going to see how I get on with using that for navigation. It's a pretty plain route anyway, so I'm not too fussed about that. But that, I'll show you the bike later, but I've got a sort of attachment that I can put that on the bike. Passport, I know it's only Ireland, it's only across the water, but it is advised that you take your passport. So I've got my passport. Motorbike documents, tax, MOT, insurance, all that kind of stuff. And an itinerary. So this is everything that I've already booked weeks in advance. I've booked the ferry crossing. So I take the ferry from Holyhead to Dublin. I'll be overnighting in North Wales the night before. Got an overnighter in Dublin. And then a sort of quick view map, snapshot of every day. So I'll be leaving here, Chippenham, up to Colwyn Bay, North Wales. That's one of the longest legs of the journey. It's, you know, 228 miles, about 3.5-ish hours. It'll probably take me a bit more because I'm not going to be darting around, etc. So I've got that for every day, just to say where I'm going, where I'm staying, the addresses, all that kind of stuff. So I will have that with me. I've got this, a hard copy, and I've got a soft copy of that as well, on a memory stick and on my laptop that I'll be carrying with me. If I've got room, I've got a BMW F650 GS. And I've got the manual there, so if I've got room, which I probably will have, I'll take that, because it's useful if you have any drama. Okay, I'll start off with the from the top then. Helmet, I've got a Kaberg Duke, I think it's called. I've fitted on it one of these Bluetooth devices. I use that to just listen to my phone. I'm not really interested in making phone calls when I'm riding, but if I use the GPS feature of my phone, obviously it can relay that to that. This, you may sort of sneer a little bit at this or tut your lips at me or whatever, but I have screw mounted one of these RAM mounts to the side of the helmet. It's for the camera. I don't much like the idea of these stick-on things. I don't trust them. So yeah, I bolted one of them on. Like it or hate it, it's on and it's staying. Bike main suit, the jacket I'll be wearing pretty much all the time. It's an Aldi special, actually. It was a bit cheap and cheerful, but it fits me very nicely. It doesn't get wet, you know, in the summer. And it is waterproof. It's tried and tested. I like it. I like the layout of the pockets. I like the armour. I've mucked around with it a little bit, but I'm very happy with that. Trousers I'll wear as and when I need them. I have a bit of problems with, I'm quite tall, and I find that the trousers generally think your knees are where they shouldn't be, halfway down your shin or something. So I tend to use these, and I can just use these with normal jeans. So I can wear normal jeans, not your special motorbike jeans, although I have got motorbike jeans, which I sometimes wear. But yeah, I use these tubey grips with protection in them because I find it more comfortable. And boots. I always wear motorbike boots. Right, the main luggage, sides and top box. Basically, the way I've sort of done this is I've got a dirty box and a clean box, if you like. A dirty box is not dirty, but I don't mind if it gets dirty. It's where I keep oil, all that kind of stuff. I've got a fire extinguisher on the top. Toolkit. Well, this is my main toolkit. This is a sort of extra toolkit of goodies that I don't normally carry, but I will carry for a longer trip. I'll go through those in a minute. So yeah, in there you've just got a bit of oil, some spray oil for the chain mainly. One of these tyre repair jobs, which I find are pretty good on cars. I've never had to use one for a bike, but I imagine it works in the same sort of manner. I've got puncture repair and inflation kit on the bike, which I'll show you later when we look at the bike and the few sort of modifications I've made to the bike. But yeah, you know, I'm not tightly packing stuff in. I'm not going to travel very very heavy. I mean, I travel quite light anyway. I'm pretty used to camping and stuff like that, although I'm not actually camping on this trip. I'm staying in hostels just because it's easier and it's actually cheaper. It works out about 15 euros a night for a hostel. It'd probably be pretty much the same for a campsite, so it's a no-brainer. Right, I'll take you through my main toolkit. Right, pump. I have got an inflation and puncture kit on the bike, which I'll show you later, but you know, I've got one of these CO2 things. If it all runs out, I've still got that. Don't want to use it because, you know, I'm getting too old for that. Right, the main kit here is just your basics, really. Gloves, and then a basic toolkit with pretty much everything that I need. Sockets, I've got a junior hacksaw with spare blades. I've got a little circuit tester, which I knocked up myself in the workshops the other day. Basically like a bulb tester, which has got an LED in the end. So that goes to earth, and then you'll find your 12 volts on that. Very basic. I was thinking about bringing a multimeter with me, but I just don't think I'd need to. This will do me fine. Yeah, basic toolkit, a few extras here. I've got one of these universal clutch stroke brake, repair cables, which I got off eBay, and I've put into this smaller sort of pack. Some wire for whatever, quite useful or can be. Some electrical wire, which I can bridge circuits or, you know, repair stuff if I need to. A spare battery for my alarm, which I keep meaning to take off the bike. I don't like it. I don't think it's necessary, but it was fitted on before I had it, so I've got a spare battery for it. I have only got one fob for the alarm, so that could be a problem. I fitted several DIN sockets on the bike and various electrical sort of socketry on it, which I'll show you later. This is obviously just something I knocked up. It's just a DIN to standard socket. Again, I use this for trickle charging occasionally, or I can use it for for jump starting, not a direct jump start, but I could charge my battery off another car and then start up. And odds and sods, bits and pieces, Jubilee clips, fuses, electrical connectors, bolts, you know, all that kind of stuff. Bits that are quite useful and that, you know, if you haven't got them and you need them, you know, there's no substituting really. Okay, the supplementary sort of toolkit that I've knocked together is just got a few sort of bulkier items in it that I may need. I've got a small soldering iron there. I've got some of this, I've got some zip ties, I've got more zip ties in here. I've always got plenty of zip ties. Rubber gloves just for mucking about with the chain. Spare bulb, I think there's a couple in there. Spare bulbs, headlight and one of the rear ones, and a spare spark plug. Some of this metal steel stick metal stuff, which is quite good if you need it. I like to avoid using it as I can, but in an emergency I'd use it. Insulation tape. I've got some Swarovski, a decent beaded hand wash soap, because if I do have to muck around on the engine, you know you're going to get covered in oil, and I don't really want to put, you know, oily hands back into expensive gloves. So that I'll sort my hands out with. The good old ubiquitous duct tape. I've got some Velcro here, which is really good stuff. It's you take that off, you have to blowtorch it a little bit, but it's fantastic stuff. May come in useful, so I'd bring a bit anyway. Again, jungle wipes, degreasing wipes for cleaning yourself off after you've had to do any work. Again, really useful. And some of this tape, which I've never used, but it sounds really good for fixing basically radiator pipes, that kind of stuff. It says it works from minus 54 degrees to plus 260. It's a silicone sort of tape that you peel off, insulate or repair whatever you need to, and just leave, basically. It's if you believe what it says on the packet, then it sounds like really good stuff. And I've got some sandpaper, which I haven't put in here yet because I got it late earlier and it's still in my jacket, and some Scotch-Brite just in case I need to stick something. I'll you know, clean up the surfaces first with that. So that is the sort of dirty box, if you like. I don't mind if you know, you get oil and stuff like that in there. It is clean now, but I'm prepared for that to get dirty if I've got a bit of a nasty job that I need to sort out. And that should all go in there quite happily. I don't have to pack it down and organise it. It'll just go in. Right, the other one is a sort of clean box. It's a more day-to-day stuff. I've got some water in there, which I can use for washing my hands after degreasing stuff and using that bead cleaner that I've got, or drinking, whatever. A pretty decent first aid kit. I've taken all the crap out that was in here originally and replaced it with decent plasters and, you know, decent stuff that I, you know, that I'd use. I've got in here some zinc oxide tape, because I'm not 100% sure. I haven't done much walking in my motorbike boots, and I might end up doing a fair bit. So if I have problems with my feet, I can just sort them out with that. Various other things, you know, that I may need. Some eyewash if you get something in your eye. Emergency blanket, various bits and bobs. That's in there. Pair of very light summer gloves. They're a little bit Alan Partridge, these are, but I quite like them. And they're very light summer gloves. It's, you know, it's one above skin, really. They're you know, that's what they are. But yeah, not sure I'll get much use out of them. I'm going to be leaving on Tuesday, sort of, you know, late March in Britain. Probably not going to get much use. My day-to-day gloves this time of year are these. They're your motorbike seal skins. Waterproof, armoured, but not winter gloves. But they work pretty well this time of year. Unless it's at night and you're on a long journey, then you'd want your winter jobs. Okay, winter jobs there. I've got these Sprada Storms. They're pretty good. I've got no complaints with them. I like them, they fit well, and they're warm. Berghaus Deluge trousers. Just quick over trousers. If I'm travelling in jeans and it starts pissing down, I just pull up and chuck these on. Simple. They do, if you're unaware of these, they do zip all the way down the leg like that. So you can put these on with motorbike boots or anything, they're just straight on. And I normally, if I'm expecting rain, I'll keep these in the back pocket, this back big pocket of my riding jacket. And then I don't even have to muck around with the side boxes, just straight in there. Right, again, in here, I've got stuff I don't want oil to come in contact with. I've got a radio, actually, which I'm not using at the moment, and I probably won't take. It's all my tie-down kit for the for luggage. I've got a high-vis, which I tend not to wear normally. I suppose I should. But, yeah, if I start hitting, you know, real hick sort of country roads and stuff like that in Ireland, then I may well wear this. Don't know. I mean, I'm not against wearing them. I just haven't worn it so far. So may well do that again. What's this? Oh, some inner silk gloves, just for them really cold days, and some proper decent tie-down stuff. Okay. So that is in the second pannier. I'll obviously tidy it all up later. Again, like I say, I don't like to travel with it all crammed in. You know, I want access to this stuff. I want it there when I need it, which is why I sort of loosely pack it, and I travel pretty light. You know, like I say, I'm not camping, so I've got that luxury. I have got a tank bag. I ride a BMW F650, which has got a false tank. The tank's under the seat. So this is not a magnetic one. It's the sort of strap down one. It's very useful. But if I can get away without using it, I will, which is purely from an aesthetic thing. You know, I don't like the way it looks on the bike. You know, it is that, you know, shallow. I do not like the way it looks on the bike. I just don't like it. It's not awkward to ride with. I just prefer not to use it. But yeah, if I did use it, it'd have, you know, a microfiber to hand and various other things, and it is pretty useful actually, and I have ridden with it before, but I tend not to use it if I don't need to. Right, tech-wise, I'm going to take a laptop, which is in here somewhere. Laptop in there. I may take the manual in there. This basically fits into here. I don't carry anything else in there. That'll just be filled up with this bag, and it will have basically all my tech. So it'll have, I've got my DSLR there, I made a little charging cable for it, the battery charger, the standard battery. It does have, and it's got in it at the moment, an AA battery sort of converter that plugs in place of that. So I'm never without power. Batteries, head torch, I've got that head torch. And to supplement the toolkit, I always carry a little lead lenser torch there, which just takes a AAA battery, and my Leatherman Surge. I always carry those with me, so I'll have those with me as well. Glasses, I don't tend to wear glasses generally when I'm riding, although I should do, and I certainly do at night. And I'm using for filming this the sort of ram mount type setup. So there's a few places on the bike that I've got these ram mount balls, and I've got a few extensions and bits and bobs for the ram mount, so I'll set up different shots and hopefully make the video a bit more watchable. Okay, inside there I've got cables, I've got these sort of USB charger things, the extra chargers for cameras, mobile phones, all that kind of stuff. So that, along with any other, I'll probably put my wash bag and a few other things in there. That will be full by the time I leave. So then, laptop, tech, all the bits and bobs, all go in there, all go in the top box. And this big, I think it's a 59 litre Ortlieb. Yeah, that is what I'll have all my personal kit in, which I won't take a great deal. I'll take a couple of changes of clothes, pants, socks, wash kit, towel, normal jacket. I'm not going to walk around for 6 days in a motorbike jacket. So that is pretty much me ready to go. I'll show you the bike next time. See you later. Again, at the bike this time. I've just done the 50 odd miles from Chippenham to my sort of family home
here in Cheltenham. Very windy today. We've had the highest winds all year, and they're set to continue for 2 days. So I've got to go from Cheltenham up to Colwyn Bay, and I don't particularly fancy the motorway, so I might have a look at alternative routes in a minute. Right, I'll just take you through the bike and a few sort of things I've done to it. Right, there's all the luggage on, what we went through earlier. And a pretty messy job really, but it's solid lashed down. Right, this is my Bluetooth controller for the headset I've got, which I haven't actually used yet really. Just some power stuff I put on for equipment that I'll be carrying. This is for my mobile phone. I've got a waterproof case for it. Camera mount here for the camera that I'm holding at the moment. And that's pretty much it for that. I've decided against using the tank bag. I didn't need it in the end. One other thing I've added to it is a sort of number plate box, and that's got my inflation and puncture repair kit in it, quite neatly away there, and obviously it's always on the bike. Small, pretty low profile box, doesn't interfere too much with the number plate illumination. Right, I've done a load of work on the bike. I've fully serviced it. I've replaced the rear shock, which was a bit of a pain, and it was worn. So yeah, fully serviced it, changed the oil, changed the filters, changed the spark plugs. This is my shock preload adjuster, which now works. It didn't work before. And before, when I got on the bike, I pretty much maxed out the suspension travel all the way down, so it was not good. New chain and sprockets. New disc pads all round, and a new rear disc, new throttle cable, new battery, just jobs I found sort of along the way really. You know, you start doing one thing and before you know it you've, you know, spent hundreds of quid and replaced the whole fucking bike. So yeah, pretty much good to go. Yeah, I'm going to meet my brother here in 20 minutes or so, have a bit of a chin wag. And then I'll be off to Colwyn Bay. See you later. Arriving in Ireland now, Dublin. I'll have a quick look round, but it's a bit windy. Thank you. Well, here I am in Dublin. That place there, pretty impressive looking chimney, is the generator. It's like a hostel I'm staying at, €15 or so a night, pretty cheap. I arrived here, the Fastcat ferry was delayed by at least an hour, so I was hanging around a bit there. I got in here, pretty knackered, had a shower, tidied it up, got some normal clothes on. I've just had a massive steak and sort of beef meal, and I'm pretty knackered, to be honest. The pace of this has taken it out of me a little bit. I expected just to be mucking around on the bike, having a bit of a jolly, turning up to places, having a look around, taking some pictures, you know, and having a relaxed old time. But especially with the weather to begin with, it, you know, it's taken it out of me. It's really been a bit of a slogger. So as you can see, it's pretty miserable here at the moment, which I'm not too fussed about. You know, I'm not being blown around the motorway on a bike, so it's not that bad. I don't want to sound all doom and gloom or anything, but you know, because I have enjoyed it, but it's just been a slog on the bike so far. Dublin, not really too fussed about. I'm going to try and have a little bit of a look around now. But yeah, once I get out tomorrow, sort of get into the roads and into the sticks of things, then, you know, hopefully I'll find my legs a bit. So, yeah, Dublin, it's a bit, it's all I've really seen of it so far. Like I say, I just got straight here, got out of the sweaty sort of kit that I've been in, and got tidied up a bit. So yeah, I'll have a bit of a look around now. See you. Yeah, I had a bit of a quick look around Dublin city centre earlier. It's a bit strange, actually. It sort of took me by surprise a bit. It's quite it's quite continental in the general feel of certain things, like the supermarkets. You've got the sort of deli section and the fruit section, and it's all quite continental, you know. In some of the little spary type places I've been to, I genuinely wouldn't feel out of place if they were in Germany, you know, or France or Belgium or something like that. It's you know, surprisingly continental. And I got some nasal decongestant earlier, so I had to go into like a chemist, and it's very continental, you know. You have to press the buzzer thing and they buzz you through, you know, as they do on the continent, because weirdly they've got this sort of high security way of dealing with, you know, chemists and that on the continent. And I saw a steaming Irishman, only a young kiddie guy, on his own with a bottle of beer in his hand, sort of walking up and down, just screaming at traffic and just talking incoherently, which was quite funny, and it sort of cheered me up a bit. Anyway, I'm going to go to bed in a minute. It's early-ish, it's 10 to 8, but I'm knackered. It's taken it out of me past it. Morning. That's me finished in Dublin now. Left the bike here overnight in an underground car park. It's taken me a little while just to put everything back on and get it all squared away. So, and it's raining outside again. A bit drizzly, but not too bad. So yeah, I'm going to head out of Dublin on the M4, and basically make my way north to Sligo. It's quite a big trip today. Don't know what the weather's going to be like, but I need to get some fuel first. So I've sorted out my packing system a bit better. I've cut down the straps and simplified it somewhat, which it needed. But it's solid, which is the main thing. So yeah, it's going to be a bit of a big day, I would imagine, today. So I'm going to get cracking. See you later.
Right, I'm finally out of Dublin and I'm on the M4, which is where I'm trying to go. It took me a little bit of a while to find it, and I'm going to have to modify my route. I'm not going to do Sligo, because the weather isn't great and it will take me a long time to get up there and round to Galway. So I'm going to go straight along the M4 to Galway. I'm on the M4 now. I've just stopped from the services to you know, get myself winterised up a bit. So yeah, I'm feeling comfortable. The kit I've got's really good. It's staying waterproof. I've just had to get my winter gloves on and this balaclava thing, and just sort my kit out a little bit more. So yeah, now it's just going to be straight motorway riding all the way. You know, sort of drizzly rain, nothing too heavy, not much wind. So yeah, should be all right. Yeah, bike going great. You know, buzzing away like a little bee, no problem whatsoever. Kit all good. I'm warm, although it's miserable here. You know, I don't feel it. So yeah, I'm quite happy at the moment. Yeah, just going to kick out 190 odd clicks to Galway. I'll get there in good time and then do a bit of exploring around there.
once was a man called Mark. Yeah, I'm in Limerick. I got up early this morning because I just fancied a bit of a ride without any traffic. Anyway, there once was a man called Mark, and he was a right bit disappointed because I come to McDonald's, which has pretty much been my second home since I came over here, and they don't actually do the big breakfast in McDonald's in Ireland. I asked for one this morning, and he sort of looked at me, and then I looked at the board, and they just don't do one. So I've got some sort of breakfasty type, wrap or whatever it is. Anyway, yeah, so finished Galway last night. Quite enjoyed it in Galway. Might have to go back there at some point. Got up early, passing through Limerick now, on my way down to Dingle. I'm going to try and get down to Dingle in reasonable good time, dump stuff off at the hostel, and go for a bit of an explore and see the sea and all that sort of thing, which I'm quite looking forward to. So, yeah, I'll give you a shout when I'm in Dingle. See you, mate. Sorry, I'm not going to let that one lie, actually. Basically, in this McDonald's, I don't know if it's the same sort of countrywide, but they don't do just an English breakfast, the big breakfast, as they call it. So anyway, I've got this, which is basically a sort of sausage, egg and bacon and cheese thing. I don't fucking know why McDonald's do this, but they just don't follow the simple rules of breakfast in Britain. You can't get a bacon and egg roll. You get a bacon, egg and cheese roll. You know, it's only fucking McDonald's that do that. You know, if you went to your local Burger Wagon and just said, oh, you know, I'll just have a bacon and cheese roll this morning, or bacon, egg and cheese, they'd look at you like you're fucking mental. You know, we do not eat bacon, egg and cheese, or bacon and cheese in the mornings, ever. You know, it's only McDonald's that do this, which is why I always order the big breakfast. And I've got fucking cheese this morning. Hello there. Just stopped about 20 kilometres shy of Tralee. I'm going to go through Tralee. I'll stop in Tralee actually for a minute. It's only 9 o'clock. I got up early this morning. I'm making plenty of time. So I'll stop in Tralee for a little bit. And then on to Dingle, and I'll have a bit of an explore around Dingle. Yeah, I had to stop here. I've no idea what this town's called. It's about 3 kilometres off the main route that I was just taking, but my arse went to sleep, so I just needed a brew in that. It's Good Friday today, and they take it pretty seriously over here, so everything's closed, you know, hospitality-wise, pubs, you know, cafes, all that sort of stuff. So it's just your one-stop shops and that kind of thing that are running. And weirdly, there's a fishmonger over there that's open as well. So I thought you might like to have a look at the bike, because it looks pretty good. It's getting a bit dirty now. But yeah, it's done me proud. It's ticking along like a fucking trooper. It really is. It's nice. I'm only taking it steady, because it's a bit blowy out there, and, you know, I'm just cruising. I can't really be arsed with all the concentration that goes with riding hard. I don't need to. I'm just taking it steady. Yeah, so I'm just going to have this quick brew and disappear. But yeah, it's a strange old place, Ireland. You know, it's weird. It's different. I mean, you've got shops like this. Check this out. You've got shops like this. You know, who the fuck shops here? Like Imelda Marcos or something? Weird, but you know, this is a whole fucking town of shops like that. It's crazy. But yeah, they, well, it works, I suppose. It's still going. So yeah, I'm on my way to Tralee. I can barely speak. I'm a bit, a bit battered by wind and whatnot. So yeah, Tralee shortly, and then on to Dingle. And I might even get to see the Atlantic. See you in a minute.
something. This is the top, or to it near the top of the Connor Pass. I noticed earlier when I stopped, there's some water leaking down from the radiator. It was only a little bit. I'm a little bit worried about it, but I'm not going to bother about that now. I'm going to get back. I'm going to get to Dingle and have a look at it there. I'll replace the radiator. Thank you.
I'm just finishing off Dingle here. I've just had breakfast, a pretty good night's sleep. Nice breakfast, Irish breakfast, which is effectively an English breakfast, without beans and without cheese, thankfully. So yeah, I'm about to shoot off from Dingle to Cork. I'm probably not going to take the coastal route. I think I've sort of, I was a bit over-ambitious in the amount of, you know, travelling I was going to do. You know, you couple that with everything else, packing up, re-establishing in wherever you're going and all that. You're sort of fighting for time a little bit. So I might take a more direct route there. For the first time out here, I'm not wearing my waterproofs. However, well, my waterproof bottoms, they're not, you know, far away, believe me. As you can see, the sky looks pretty miserable. So I'll probably chuck them on, actually, before I leave. I'm going to take the Connor Pass again, which I took yesterday. Lovely road, mountain road, nice and windy, perfect sort of motorbiking road. So I'm going to take that out of here, up to Tralee. I might even stop for a brew in Tralee again, like I did yesterday. I thought I had a bit of a coolant leak yesterday. I saw coolant dripping down here when I was going up a sort of mountain road. I took the bike apart, took these panels off, had a look at it. I did actually replace the radiator on this about a month ago or so ago, because it had been bodge repaired with some of that fucking metal plastic stuff, and it was a shit job. He probably did it in situ, didn't do it properly. Anyway, I got rid of that and got a decent second-hand one on eBay, so I was pretty sure I'd fitted it all right. So anyway, I took it off yesterday, and I think I've just overfilled the reservoir. So I'm not worried about that. That's all cool. I had a quick once over the bike, oiled the chain, mucked about a bit yesterday. This is pretty good. This is a top tip. I've got one of these charging things. That'll charge my smartphone about 3 or 4 times. It also charges the camera that I'm speaking at now, and anything else that you can charge off a USB. As with yesterday, I turned up to the hostel. It was full of fucking teenage Germans. They were all asleep. They'd all plugged in everything they own, and I didn't have any charging points. So I charged everything off this thing here. And now while I'm riding, because it's semi-waterproof, it's not submersible, but it's waterproof. As you can see on my power sort of equipment here, I'll plug it in and that'll charge happily on my way up to Cork, and then I can use that again to charge all my devices. So yeah, I'm on me merry old way, and I'll see you later.
That's me finished Cork now. Didn't really do much filming around Cork. I was up early this morning, just because I like to, especially in cities, I like to be sort of free from all the traffic, and it's quite nice riding around in the sort of early morning. I've just stopped at this service station. Service stations in Ireland are fantastic. This one, I had a full cooked breakfast, tea, coffee, a pint of milk. I'm properly ready to go now. I had a bit of a hunger on this morning, so I've sorted myself out a bit. I tend to visit a lot of service stations out here because I've got a slight fuel problem. I have to fuel up before I hit around 100 miles because I've got a bit of an issue with the bike that I know about, and I'm sort of living with it. I'll sort it out when I get back. But yeah, weather's improving. It's cold this morning. Obviously, I've left my waterproofs off. I've got them with me just in case, but I don't think I'll be needing them, although it is a bit chilly, but that'll pass in half an hour or so. Yeah, really nice place, Cork, friendly, like all of Ireland. You know, the people are friendly, and, just come up and chat to you if if they see the bike or whatever. You know, it's really nice. I've got about, I'm just going to take the pretty direct route, the M8, all the way up to Kilkenny today. I was just speaking to a taxi driver there. He says it's a pretty straightforward route, and nice, and quite scenic, even on the motorway. So, I'm just going to
crack straight on and go up there. If I get there early, I'll just do a bit of riding around and exploring around there. Yeah, the hostel last night was pretty good. It was a big place, a big sort of big old joint. We ended up with four in a six-man room in the end. A couple of people came in the night. And yeah, like I say, I went to bed early. I only had a quick look around Cork last night. Went to bed early, so, you know, up early and away. So, yeah, I'm going to crack on now and make me merry old way to Kilkenny. Got to have a look at this. I mean, it's an absolute dream come true. There's no wind, the sun's come out now, and this is a completely empty motorway. It's like being in, you know, Nevada or something like that. It's unbelievable. You know, oh, the car now. The car. I mean, I've been sitting here for about, well, I've been here for about 15 minutes now. There was a period of about 5 solid minutes where there wasn't a thing. All you could hear was the crows. It's absolutely lovely. Karma crossing this time on the way back. Just on my way back now from Rosslare to Pembroke. It's going to take about 4 hours, twice as long as the fast cap on the way over here. Yeah, had a good time last night in Kilkenny. Nice little town, you know, busy little town, plenty of pubs, you know, quite a buzz to the place. It was good. But yeah, this is it. This is the last leg. I get off at Pembroke Dock, and then I've got a 100-odd mile ride back to Chippenham. Yeah, I've had a good time. I've enjoyed it. Nice, friendly people, the Irish, and Ireland is different. It's different than old Blighty, the rest of Britain. And I've enjoyed it. I'll definitely go back. But yeah, I've had a little taste of it. I've seen a couple of the big cities and a few of the more sort of rural areas. Roads are fantastic. I didn't have great weather for the first couple of days, but it certainly improved after the first couple of days, and the riding was fantastic. I mean, you know, as you saw, I had an empty motorway, you know, decent rural winding roads, you know, not crazy traffic like you can get in most of Britain. It was good, really enjoyed it, and I will be back. But I've got work tomorrow. Chips whistle, just because of the fog. Yeah, so I'll go back to work tomorrow and start planning a summer jaunt to Scotland, I think. Nice to have you along. See you later. Bye.